Hold the plan. What are you doing?
Playing a little handball.
Does it feel like it's been 50 years?
Pong, invented by Atari.
Now that I'm 74 years old, it feels like at least 50 years. When we started, we were all young engineers under 30.
The memories are fresh, and it was a special time, so I look back on it with a great deal of fondness. I think Pong opened up the doors of things that were possible, that you didn't necessarily have to do things the traditional way.
That's where I met Nolan, was at Ampex. While he was there, designed computer space, and one day he and Ted came over to Ampex where I was, just a junior engineer, and offered me $1,000 a month salary and 10% of the stock. And I was making 1,200 bucks a month at Ampex at the time. But this seemed like a lot more fun. So he gave me the simplest possible game that's ever been thought of, which is Pong, one moving object, two scores, and a net. I didn't think Pong would be a good idea, but I just happened to have the right skills to do it. And we did it, put it out there, and holy moly, it took off.
Speed. The chips didn't like to go fast. Color burst and things like that was 3.58 megahertz. The chips started running out of gas at a megahertz. And so we were always trying to do tricky things to make up for that 3 megahertz gap.
Banks wouldn't talk to us, and we didn't have any venture capital at that time. They wouldn't talk to us. The electronic component suppliers like Mauser's were the first ones that would give us 90 days credit. And it's so simple, we could buy the parts and turn them into finished games within 2 weeks. We could turn inventory that fast. So we didn't have any manufacturing experience, so Nolan, I think, went down to the unemployment office to hire people. Our competitors would just copy our board and buy the parts and plug them in. I think we made about 3,000 or 4,000 Pong machines. Nolan thinks we made more, but I think the industry made about 15,000, 20,000. From the way I see it, Mauser's niche is they've always provided a very cost-effective solution. You can get a lot of components much cheaper, more accessible. Mauser was more open, more public, you know, send us a check, we'll send you the parts.
I was introduced to Mauser actually at Ampex, where I worked before I started Atari and Syzygy. They were very, very instrumental, and so ordering was easy, fulfillment was fast. I think they had a distribution center right in the Silicon Valley, so you could actually drive up and get stuff. You make it so easy to buy something that why would you go anywhere else? A lot of people don't realize that all the video games from 1970 through about 1976, 77 were all state machines. That is, they were not von Neumann architecture. There was no software. It was all built in hardware, because the microprocessor had just barely been invented and they weren't very good. Anybody could have invented the video game once the microprocessor was strong enough.
So it was all TTL chips, the 7400 series. The availability of these cheap, high-speed semiconductors was really, really critical.
I hate to say this out loud, but Al was a better engineer than I was. And though I created the original technology, Al was picked it up and put it on steroids. Pong was sort of accidentally hit all the boxes of good game design. In the coin-op world, good game design required that it was instantly understandable as to what you do and how to play. The second thing that it had is the balance between risk and reward was very good. If you hit the corner of the paddles, that would give an obtuse angle that was hardest to return. However, trying to get that shot gave you a higher probability of missing the ball entirely. So it's that risk of loss versus getting a good offensive shot. And that's a really good thing in game design.
Pong was designed so that you could get yourself involved in athletics while maintaining a firm grip on a can of beer. The fact that anybody could play it, and it wasn't themed, people don't want to buy technology, they want to buy entertainment, they want to have fun.
Invented by Atari. Now at last you can play at home.